Hello. I had been working through that stagnation in the hip area, getting more flow, and then my phone ran out of space, which was good because I really had no set direction. I was just mulling out loud. And anyways, one of the viewers had asked, how often should you upload? And I had found that interesting. The most common phrase people would probably use would be a download. But when you think about, the true nature of all of us is that we're one. And if a God asked you, how would you upload? And you flip that around and see the inner divinity of you, the expansiveness of your soul. And you ask yourself, your inner divinity, I am a God, your I am presence. You feel into your I am presence and you reach into the upload. And your I am presence is your awareness of inner divinity. This is, and an upload, that's when you're pulling information from galactic stars, from the unseen things. Like if you're a god and you can't, think about everything at once, you would compartmentalize it and you would expand and feel and merge into it. At our highest essence, we're all one. So you're tapping into that. And when you're uploading, that's when you're going from your I am presence into your internal landscape and you're feeling within yourself and validating all the isness of you. How often should you do that? It kind of depends on how connected you want to be with yourself. Sometimes it's an uncomfortable conversation. And that's when you want to download. And that's more earthing energy. But that's just how I feel those two words. Sometimes uploading for me is like sitting at the principal's office, and I don't do it till I'm damn good and ready. And hear the static. I don't know if you can hear the airplane going off with the headphones, but yeah, it's a little bit like that. It's I know you got a message for me. I know you're trying to say something. Your intent loud and clear, but I'm not sitting down to listen. Uploading cuts away the static. But when you force yourself to do it, when you make yourself meditate, when you make yourself do 1,000 hours of this and get very rigid and set, it constricts and it's all just static anyway, so you're not uploading or downloading. You're inert, and that's the blocks that the different levels of how you process your reality and feel your spirituality, those blocks start to move and shift. I'm often having a conversation with God in my head, and and I'll feel a nudge to do something, and it's like, no, I'm not talking to you right now. And that is beautiful stagnation. We go through ebbs and flows of how much we want to connect this way and how much we want to connect this way. This is a flow through our chakra systems, a balance through our doingness and our isness. In a lot of spiritual beliefs, they're working to attainment for quiet or zen or oneness, peace, stillness. But truly, it's unity consciousness. We're reaching for more connection with ourself and more awareness of our rambling. Strength preservation 11. Where we gather our strength, awareness of self. That's I got into biohacking, patient zero. That's when you take you into account. I was going through all these weird symptoms and trying to manage life through physical blocks and not seeing their connection. So with the biohacking, I got into this heart coherency, and it's like the spacing in between your heartbeat. There's it's like your heart knows what's coming, and there's a calmness when you're tapped into it. And often you can mathematize and put on a grid this space in between your heart, and you can speed it up and slow it down and blah blah blah. It was this really neat app I got off of Dave Asprey. He made this ear thing, and I stuck it onto my phone, and I looked at these pictures, and I breathed with it, and yada yada yada. I was meditating. I didn't know that. For me, it was a fun app with colors. But more than that, it was this, there it is, there it is, there it is, there it is. Now, those moments of there it is was a crystalline grid structure, a ease of upload. Creating a hyperlink to you.